On Sunday the 8th of May 2022, otherwise known as Mother's Day, the Pahiatua Railcar Society used one of their standard railcars to run an excursion from Palmerston North to National Park and back. I began my chase of RM31 at the site of the Tangiwai railway disaster, but just before the railcar showed up, I was joined by Hamish, otherwise known as Lift and Rail Photography in NZ. The standard railcars were built in 1938, and ran an NZR service right up until 1972. Throughout their long service life, they were used on a variety of rural passenger runs throughout the North Island, most famously the Wellington to New Plymouth run. There were 6 of these things built, and 4 have been preserved. The survivors are RM30 at the Silverstream Railway, RM32 at the Glenbrook Vintage Railway, then RMs 31 and 34 in Pahiatua, though 31 is currently the only standard that's mainline certified. During the layover at National Park, RM31 ran 2 shuttle trips up to the Raurimu Spiral and back. I ended up being a passenger on the first shuttle, and filmed my perspective of the run down the spiral. The last time I rode along this section was in May 2021, when I was on the Northern Explorer to Wellington. On that occasion, DFB 7199 was hauling the train.
We also ask that you please do not turn the seats. A bit of a logistical nightmare changing the seats over while passengers are on board, so you will be travelling backwards up the spiral back through the National Park. Now that we're underway, I will tell you a little bit about the Raurimu Spiral, just so you've got a bit of insight as to how and when it was built. So the Raurimu Spiral is considered an engineering masterpiece. In 1898, its design cemented the route through the North Island Main Trunk Railway through the Central Plateau. Engineer Robert West Holmes' design for the Raurimu Spiral provided an inspired solution to the steep descent from just above Raurimu Township down into Raurimu itself. This is a height difference of around 220 metres. The design for the Raurimu Spiral would allow the sudden drop in altitude to take place while maintaining a manageable 150 gradient and at a comparatively cheap cost. Its descent from the central plateau, the Raurimu Spiral consists of two tunnels, the first being 385 metres long, the second 96 metres long. This allows the track to overlap and wind around in a circle before exiting through two quarter turns and a horseshoe bend just south of Raurimu Station. So as we travel over the spiral, you'll be able to look back and see where we have travelled on our descent down into Raurimu. Thank you.
Upon arrival back at National Park, we found KiwiRail's train 240 waiting in the second loop for the southbound 247. Only the first two locomotives were running, while DL9089 was being towed dead. When DLs 9567 and 9014 finally showed up, they helped make a somewhat unusual scene. In other words, it's a very rare thing for all three tracks at National Park to be occupied.